Fossils help us tell time.
I think it's a brachiopod.
Imagine, 365 million years into the future, our remains will tell people what time period our fossils were from. Fossils help us define when deposits were laid down and help us tell what age the rocks are from. Over long spans of time, new organisms evolve, thrive, and eventually go extinct. Geologists specializing in the study of ancient life through fossils have mapped out which species live at which time. If you went swimming in the ocean during the Devonian period, things would look very different than they do today. There were extensive reefs, but they were not built by the coral that make up modern reefs. Organisms called stromatoporoids that secreted layers upon layers to construct massive and widespread structures were the primary reef builders. Instead of clams and other bivalves dominating marine communities, there were different types of shelled critters called brachiopods that were abundant. Trilobites also crawled around on the seafloors and swam in shallow waters. During the Devonian, we also see dramatic and fascinating changes on land. This is the first time in the history of the planet that there were forests. This drastic increase in vegetation changed everything. This is an era of many first things that we now take for granted. This was the development of soils for the very first time, as well as the oxygen produced and the carbon dioxide removed from the atmosphere by these land-based plants completely transformed not only the atmosphere, but the climate. Without these changes, we would not be able to live and breathe on Earth today. The Devonian provides a great example of a lot of these types of changes laid out beautifully for us to study. One of the areas that Devonian geologists study is the Great Basin, which includes this area we're standing in right now in Utah. When we study an area with layers of sediments, we look into the mountains and valleys and rocks in the vicinity to really understand how it fits into a broader context and piece together what the environment might have looked like millions of years ago. We know that this area was underwater around 365 million years ago at the end of the Devonian period. Since all those millions of years ago, this particular area has been pulled apart by plate tectonics and creates the mountains and valleys. And as a result, it's really a geologist's playground. As you approach a section and scan the layers from the bottom to the top, you can see the changes through time. And if you look closely, there's even some little fossil shells here. At the bottom of these sections, geologists can identify abundant and varied fossils, which indicate a healthy ecosystem. As you continue going through the strata, walking up through time, you start to see fewer and fewer fossils. There will be layers that are absent of fossils. And this is where we identify the mass extinction. But if you continue going further up, again, there are abundant and diverse fossils. And paleontologists can look at the fossils before and after the extinction event and use it as a clue to help understand what might have caused this catastrophic event. We use hammers and chisels to break away pieces of rock from each layer. We then can find evidence of all sorts of different types of life, from worms to clams to corals that would have lived under a Devonian ocean. Between visual inspection and analysis under a microscope back at the lab, we catalog which creatures are fossilized in which parts of the section. From that, we can cross-reference with sections from around the world. We can then confirm that a large majority of species went extinct at the same time. The events that transpired at the end of the Devonian decimated the enormous reef ecosystems, nearly wiped out all of the trilobites, and completely changed marine communities forever. One of the factors being studied by geologists and a key cause of mass dying is a condition called anoxia. An means not, and oxia, which means oxygen. In simple terms, this is when, in the ocean, there is a complete lack of oxygen. All animals require oxygen to survive, so this becomes particularly inconvenient. One of the types of rocks called shale, including this black shale here in central New York, is one of the indicators we use to identify anoxia. The deposits that were laid down during the periods of anoxia turn into black shale like this. The black color indicates that there was a lot of organic matter and no oxygen to help them break down and decay. Anoxia was likely a global event that potentially affected life everywhere during the late Devonian. Fossils don't just tell us the story. They are the story. They give us clues into every aspect of what happened over the millions of years, how ecosystems existed before the die-off, how they became overwhelmed, how they died out, which species survived, and the conditions that helped pick the winners and the losers. Not all fossils are big enough to see with the naked eye. Let's look at how we use chemistry to dig in further.